beautiful people. Welcome back to our safe haven. Happy Black History Month again. We're still in the month of February, so power to ya. For those of you who don't already know me, I'm Opel, and you can call me Belle. Here on this channel, you already know I aim to inspire you by sharing my Christian life journey and how I balance my lifestyle through faith, fashion, wellness, and more. So with that being said, if you're interested in all things positive, inspirational, and spiritual growth, please subscribe so you can stay connected. Thank you. Yeah, I have to deal with this every time. I'm sorry. Well, I want us to dive into an important topic that may guide you in your journey to being a stronger Christian. So with that being said, the word of the day is deception. Like always, you know what to do. Grab a cup of tea. Find your little cozy spot. And let's talk about how to deal with deception from a Christian perspective. Now, when we talk about deception, honey, don't get it twisted. I want you to understand that even the devil can perform what looks like miracles. Y'all remember when Aaron turned the rod into a serpent? Y'all remember that, right? With him and Moses? The magicians did the same thing. However, the magician's serpents were swallowed up by Aaron's rod because theirs was inferior. The devil will have you believe that he has blessed you. But when the devil is offering something that may seem to be of magnitude to you, it's an act because he always seeks an exchange. And unfortunately, that exchange often ends up being more costly than we could ever anticipate. Let's read Genesis 3, verse 1. Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God has made. And he said to the woman, "Has God indeed said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden?" Y'all see how he did that, right? The devil knows how to manipulate us into believing his lies. So it's really easy to fall for his tricks. Eve fell victim to the serpent's cunning words in the Garden of Eden, which led to the fall of all humans. That also shows us that deception can be disguised as a seemingly harmless conversation. Now let's read Luke 22, verse 3 to 4. Then Satan entered Judas, surnamed Iscariot, who was numbered among the 12. So he went his way and conferred with the chief priests and captains how he might betray him to them. Now let's talk about my dog Judas, okay, and how he betrayed Jesus with a deceitful kiss. He not only allowed the devil to play into his greed and sinful nature, but the devil even got him to believe there was no redemption for him, which cost him his life. This could have ended so much more differently if Judas just asked God for forgiveness and not tried to take matters into his own hands. This is what I mean earlier, that an exchange between the devil ends up being more costly. In John 10, verses 10, it says, "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I," meaning Jesus, "have come that they may have life and have it to the full." When God blesses you, his exchange is a bonus because following him and his word leads us to a greater fulfilling life. I believe as Christians, we are entrusted with the gift of discernment and are called to discern these deceptive exchanges, but we just have to learn how to cultivate that gift. And I wanna share with you three best ways that we can actually learn to discern the devil's scheme. The first way is to study the scriptures. Okay, dive deep into the Bible to understand God's character, his promises, and the principles guiding a Christian life. Familiarize yourself with the Word of God as it serves as a powerful tool for discernment. When you know God's truth, it becomes easier to identify falsehood and deception. Scriptures I want you to consider is, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." Psalms 119, verse 105. The second way is to cultivate a strong prayer life. Develop a consistent and fervent prayer life. Through prayer, seek guidance, wisdom, and spiritual discernment from God. The Holy Spirit who dwells within believers provides insight and help distinguish between God's leading and the devil's deceptive schemes. Remember this verse: "If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. James 1 verse 5. And lastly, stay connected to a faith community. Engage with other believers and participate in a supportive faith community. Surrounding yourself with actual spiritually mature individuals provides additional perspectives and insight. Accountability, mutual encouragement, and shared wisdom can actually help you navigate challenges and discern the devil's lies more effectively. Keep this verse in mind. Iron sharpens iron, and one man sharpens another. Proverbs 27, verse 17. Y'all know y'all love that verse. I pray that you can actually combine a solid understanding of scripture, a vibrant prayer life, and the support of faith community to enhance your ability to discern the devil's schemes and walk confidently in God's truth. If you don't remember anything today, I want you to remember that God's blessings are free with no hidden agendas. His grace is a sweet bonus for those earnestly following his path. But the devil, on the other hand, offers with ulterior motives, always seeking to exploit and manipulate you. So thank you again for joining yet another of my Christian TED Talks. And if you found this video inspiring, hit that like button, subscribe for more, and share it with someone who needs a reminder. Stay blessed. And remember, you are loved beyond measures by your Heavenly Father. Bye.